Gemini 3.0 Pro launched this week, and since then I've been seeing these cool designs on Twitter. Websites like this, hero sections like this one. The design is very modern. It does not look like AI at all.
And when I tried it myself, initially I was getting designs that looked something like this. But after making some tweaks in my prompts and just understanding how the model works, I was able to get designs that were looking actually good. You know, designs like these. This is my own website that I created for my agency. I was delaying this task for over a couple of weeks now, but I eventually created it with Gemini 3. And if you look at this website here, all of this was created with just one prompt. This looks pretty modern. There's a moving element on the right. And if you scroll down, you also see all the people that have worked with us. Then there is also a comparison on how working with us is different. This glowing animation behind these cards. And then the CTA button, the examples of the things that we can build out. And finally, a section just introducing myself. I would have honestly paid someone $500 just to create this landing page for me. So in this video, I would be showing you what process I followed for this and what are the principles that I discovered while creating this website. I can honestly just give away the prompt, but in this video, I want to go through each of these principles and tell you that how I have used them while creating this website. Give a man a fish, you feed him for a day. Teach a man how to fish and you feed him for ages or something like that. So although you can just jump to the end of this video and get the prompt directly from there, but still I would be just talking through all the guidelines that I discovered. So the first one is using a hybrid persona. You might have heard this before that using a persona really helps with AI. But now using a hybrid persona, something that combines two roles, something like a creative director and backend engineer, it's what works better with Gemini 3.0 Pro. And you can get that from the example. You are an award-winning creative technologist. You are known for brutalist design and clean React code. Also, I would want you to actually follow through the video and just open up your own cursor. Or if you don't have cursor, you can also use anti-gravity, which is free to use right now. I will drop the links for both of them below. But rather than just watching through this video, I would want you to also follow through. Now, the next thing is don't just use the color names. Don't say just blue or red. Rather than that, describe the texture, what lighting you want, what exact hex code colors you want. You know, something like you use deep obsidian matte background and then giving the hex code of that color and also defining how you would want to glow within that. So all of those things matter a lot. So the third one is anti-slop rule. This basically says that rather than playing it safe with boring defaults like, using the inter font or using very simple layouts, we would want it to use something that does not look generic. This just helps the model to come up with something new that makes your website stand out. And the third thing is using structured formatting, XML or Markdown. I personally use Markdown when I'm creating my prompts so that it's easier for the AI model to understand that where are the rules, where are the tasks. Then the fifth thing is really technically specific. If you want a specific look, then you need to name out how exactly you want it to be built out, what are the libraries that would be involved. If you are a seasoned developer or a seasoned vibe coder, then you would know that what libraries you use every time. But if you don't know that, then it's just better to drop this instruction in ChatGPT or Gemini, whichever AI you are using, and let it do the research for you. Then the sixth thing is include the planning step, like ask explicitly your model to use chain of thoughts. Once it puts out time for thinking through how it wants to structure the entire repository, like creating different components, then it creates a better output rather than just rushing it. And finally, something that is not required for every website, using physics and motion. Static designs look good. A lot of websites are static and still looks good. But if you want that jaw-dropping effect, people asking you how you created your website, then you need to have animation for sure. And for this, you need to use specific vocabulary, using stagger, spring, ease and out, you know, terms that designers usually use for specifying how you want the motion within your website. Now, how do we use it? For that, I will just take a quick screenshot of this and I will use this along with my prompt in Gemini. You can also get it from the description down below. I will just copy this and then I will go to a new window in Gemini. I will just drop this here and then I will ask it, based on the instructions above, I want to create a website for my agency. Along with this, I already created a slide deck for my agency some time back. So I would be using some of the images from there to add the content here. Let me just drop them here. So these images basically has the content that I would want to show on the website. It also has details about my own background. So you can just drop text on what kind of content you want within your website. Or if you already have any asset, you can just drop it here. So my prompt is, based on the instructions above, I want to create a website for my agency. Please reference the instructions for creating a prompt that I can use within AI app builder like Cursor. And then I will also talk through how I want my entire website to be. I've already done this one time before making this video, so I will just copy this from here. My prompt here is, don't build the website, get the content and copy it from this deck. So what happens with Gemini sometimes is, it actually starts building the website in the chat itself, but we don't want to do that here. We want to do it in Cursor. And then I've described, I want a header with name of all the sections, links to jump to that. And, you know, then basically a hero section after the header, and then a ribbon that is moving slowly with the logos of the client, then a CTA button, then a section showing before and after comparison, everything that I want in the website. If you let AI assume, then it will most probably create something that you don't want. So I will just paste this here and I will send this. Based on this, most probably it will come up with a prompt that we can use within Cursor. If you are using Cursor for the first time, then I would recommend you to go with anti-gravity instead. Anti-gravity is this new tool created by Google, which is free to use right now. You just need to download the Mac app. If you don't have a Mac, then Cursor is a better option for you. Anyways, both of these have free plans that you can use at the start. I would be using Cursor in this video. For downloading Cursor, you just need to go on Cursor's own website, which is cursor.com. You can just download it based on your own system. And once you download it, you would be redirected on this screen. This is the home screen. I have a pro plan, but this would look exactly same if you are on the free plan as well. Now click on open project. When you do that, you would be prompted to select a folder within your own desktop. I already have a folder where I want to create this website. You will see that I've already tried creating this website 5 times in the past, but I did not end up creating that and deploying that. Hopefully this time I would be using the website that I just created. So let me just create a new folder to show you how it would be this time. So I will create Gemini 3 Pro and I will call it latest. I will just click on open and this would open this up on Cursor. I will just click on this icon on top left called new file. And within this, I will call this prompt.md. And here I have the editor where I have to just paste the prompt that I got. If you're using Cursor for the first time, this is how the platform looks. On the right is how you communicate with Cursor. On left, you see all the files that are created by the agent. So now we have the entire markdown. I will just copy this code from here and I will paste this here. So this has all the details on how it needs to create my website. So for now, I will just ask it to go through the prompt and create the website for my agents. Along with that, I will also add with this one liner, ask me if you have any questions, so that it can just ask me if there is any ambiguity anywhere. I will select Gemini 3 Pro here, far better than any other model when it comes to creating designs, at least. For writing code, definitely there are better options. I'm also creating a video for that in some time. So do subscribe if you want to be updated when I launch that video. But yeah, it does not have any further questions. So I will just ask it to proceed from here. And then it will take its own sweet time to come up with the entire website. You can just turn it off, grab a coffee, and then come back to it. In my case, this is the output that I got with Cursor when I tried it for the first time. Honestly, I'm pretty impressed with this. The only change would be just adding a form for the contact us section. And then just adding my own Twitter, LinkedIn, email link. Do let me know in the comments if you have any questions. And that's all for this video. I will see you in the next one.